Hello and welcome back to the engineering drawing course. This is section 5, section of solids. In the previous section, that is projection of solids, we have completed the drawing of projections of solids. That is, we have seen that when a solid is positioned on reference planes, its front view and top view can be projected, and we have also drawn them. Here we are going to have section of solids. So we'll understand first what is section. So first we'll see what is a sectional view actually. Section in the context of engineering drawing means cut. That means in our subject, in engineering drawing, whenever the term section appears, the students have to understand that it is being cut. And sectional view is also an orthographic view, which can be front view, top view or the side view, and it is obtained by cutting the solid with an imaginary section plane. Section plane here means cutting plane. So sectional view means a view which can be front view, top view or side view, and this has been obtained by cutting the solid with an imaginary section plane. So this is very important. Section means cut, cutting plane means section plane. So why we are going to learn this sectional views? See, orthographic projections are enough even for complicated figures, but some drawings become difficult to understand even if you draw them carefully. For that reason, we have sectional views. In sectional views, we'll cut the figure to reveal the internal features of an object. For example, if there is a block and inside there is a hole. To reveal that hole, we will cut that block and the hole will get revealed. So the possible orientations of section planes are, so the section plane can be placed with respect to HP and VP in the following manner: section plane parallel to HP, section plane parallel to VP, section plane inclined to HP and perpendicular to VP, section plane inclined to VP and perpendicular to HP, section plane inclined to both HP and VP. Here I will, in the next part of this video lecture, I am going to show you section plane with reference to HP, but while solving exercises we will see all these cases one by one. So first, in the first case, let us see section plane parallel to HP. So, and let's just assume that the section plane is being perpendicular to VP. So now here you see that when you cut something horizontally, the section plane will become parallel to HP. Because if this is your section plane, if this is your section plane and this is the VP, if this is the front view of any object, if this is the front view of any object, if this is HP, a line in this fashion will be parallel to this plane HP. So this plane, this cutting plane is now parallel to HP. So to illustrate that concept, we have seen a cone. When it is viewed from front, it will form a triangle, and from the top it will have a circle with apex point at the center. So this is the front view and this is the top view. When the section plane is parallel to HP, as you can see here, if I remove this portion, front view will not be a triangle anymore. It will look something like this. Only this portion will get left. And in the top view, one more circle will be visible, which you can observe here in dark. And this will be represented in hatching lines. This sectioned portion will be represented in hatching lines here in the top view. And this is going to be called sectional top view. So When the section plane is parallel to HP, we will get sectional top view. And in front of you, we'll just see the remaining portion. And you can see that here. So the second case. Yeah, this is not the second case, but just to explain you, I'm taking sectional plane perpendicular to HP. Also, let us assume it is perpendicular to VP also. So when a section plane is perpendicular to HP and VP, it will cut the solid in this fashion, as you can see here. Let us assume this is the front view of this object. When you cut from the section plane, and you can observe this portion has been removed from here. So we'll take that example of cone once again. This is the cone. This is its front view and top view. If it is not cut, that means if it is not been cut by a sectional plane. But when you cut this with the sectional plane perpendicular to HP and VP, we will be having half front view and half top view also, and its side view will reveal its internal features, and this will be in hatching lines. This is the right hand side view which we have drawn on the left hand side. You see one more time here, if I cut this from this side perpendicular to HP and VP, this portion here will get removed, as you can observe here in the front view and in the top view. So there will be no hatching lines in the front view and top view, but this black color indicates here that this is going to be in hatching lines. So I'll explain you about hatching lines while solving the problems. Do not worry about that. You just need to observe that this is the sectioned portion which is visible from the right hand side. So I'll see one more case here. Section plane inclined to HP. So in the previous two cases we have seen that section plane parallel to HP, section plane perpendicular to HP. Now section plane is being inclined to HP. So the section plane will cut the solid with some inclination angle with respect to the HP. As you can see here, this portion will get removed and this will be only left in the front view. So again, our problem of cone. This is our cone. If you do not cut the cone, you will have this front view and you will have this top view. But when I have the section plane here, this portion will get removed and only this will be visible in the front view. And when you view this from the top view, you will find some shape like this. This is called, this is very similar to a shape called ellipse. Here, this portion, this is the actual sectional top view which will be left. And this we will draw in hatching. That means we will have hatching lines here. So this is the third case when the section plane is inclined to HP. You can see the plane being inclined. And I am showing you just a line here, but please don't make mistake. This is going to be a plane. That means it will cut the solid completely, not just the half portion. So I have removed this. That is why you don't have anything here. So from the next lecture onwards, we will solve problems by taking different cases of the section plane with respect to HP and VP.